Hi friends, welcome all of you back to my YouTube channel. This is Virtual Tech Show Time for One. So today I'm going to show you the way that you can fix the GPT version of Fastboot image errors on Moto G5 Plus device in the process of recovery and flashing the original firmware for this Motorola G5 Plus device. And this video is especially for the persons who have XT1685 devices. I don't know whether XT64 or 66 or devices in this model will work this or not. Okay friends, then you need to download the firmware file for your mobile. Here I have downloaded my firmware file. Then you need to open that firmware file and extract all of these files into a new folder. Select all of them and extract them into a new folder like this. You can see I have already extracted these files into this folder. My all files are here. Then what I have done is I have downloaded this firmware fix file. You also can download this firmware fix file for Moto G5 Plus XT1685 devices from the given link in the description of this video. Then you need to select this GPT bin file and bootloader image file and extract both of these files into this extracted firmware folder like this. You can drag and drop. So then it will come to this kind of message in your Windows. Then you need to click on this replace the files in the destination option. Then it will be okay. If those two files were unable to fix the problem, you need to also add this recovery image file to this folder. But I am not going to use this recovery image file, because of my device only has the errors in Fastboot image file and the GPT partition. So what you can do is, then you need to open RSD Lite application. I think if you have faced this problem, you also have this RSD Lite software. So I'm not going to give those files. So then you need to click on here, and then here you need to select Fastboot files .xml. And then you need to find the folder where you have extracted the firmware. In my case, it's on the desktop. Then new folder 2, and here's the firmware file that I have extracted. Then here you can see the flashfile.xml file. Then select it and click on open. Now your firmware will be loaded here, and you can start flashing the firmware on your mobile from pressing this start button. I have already flashed this firmware file after modifying it on my mobile, so I'm not going to flash it once again. So you can fix your problem from flashing this modified firmware. So thank you all for watching this video. Please subscribe my YouTube channel, turn on notification and join with me.